70 or so lift stations. What's a lift station? That's what lifts up all the raw sewage from the whole city and gets it down to the sewer plant. Well, you know, most of these pumps are submersible. Well, they're supposed to be underwater, but their control panels are not. So therefore, you got control panels, you got a piece of conduit that goes to the control panel, it gets wet, the water makes its way down to the control panel, gets into the motor and burns it up. So we had emergency repairs we had to do, and I think we spent about $2 million on emergency infrastructure repairs just on pumps. And wells, seven water wells that we have was a similar situation. So in addition to emergency repairs, we're also trying to do long-term repairs, which FEMA will help us with. And again, it's a 90-10 match, or 90-10, where we pay 10%. And so what we're trying to do the best that we can is to mitigate further issues if it happens again. I would be remiss if I don't do what I have to do as mayor to prepare us for a future event, then I have failed in my duties. The distasteful part of that is when sometimes you have to talk about somebody raising their home. But we're far enough along in the process now, some of these things are starting to make more sense even to me. And we'll have to cross those bridges when we get to them. And sometimes we just have to think outside the box. You know, just because you're asking somebody to raise their home, it doesn't mean it has to look like something you see at Grand Isle. There are some things you can do cosmetically to make it look attractive. So the first floor looks like the first floor, but it's really not. Until the flood gets here, you back your cars out of a parking intersection and everything's good. Yeah. So those are the kinds of thinking that we have to work on going forward.